more than 200 sensational new and original candy bars, each with a different center, and each sweeter, creamier, and more delicious than the next. I have created chewing gum that never loses flavor, no matter how many times you chew it, and rich chrome that changes color every 10 seconds as it dissolves delectably in your mouth. I have also created the biggest and best chocolate empire the world has ever seen. But I have no one to use. No one to replace me. No one to make new candy dreams come true once I retire. And alas, the time for me to retire is long overdue. Please gather together all the Oompa-Loompas. I have an important announcement to make.
Chocolate, 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 choc you randomly twisted into place like the toothpaste factory in your life?
As of last night, Charlie, my career total stands at 2,429,876.
Wow! That must be a world record!
Close.
One day, I might be able to get a job at the toothpaste factory, Papa.
For your sake, I hope not, Charlie.
What kind of positive thinking is that? Charlie's going for Mr. Wonka to get the candy box.
Now, Grandpa Joe and Uncle Phil and the boys head with dreams of you.
Brandy? I love one.
Here you go, Pop.
I thought we were playing gin. While young Charlie Buckstar had a long uphill trek towards school, along the way, Charlie heard some exciting news.
Did you hear? Some kid got first row ticket.
Thank you. extraordinary contest. Let's just hope one deserving kid is above five. Out.
Thank you. Surprise! Happy birthday, Charlie!
Surprise! Happy birthday, Charlie!
Where did you send that?
When?
Do you know who's surprise?
Yes, he's very clever.
Presents! Presents!
Presents!
Here you go, my love. It's from all of us.
Well, why don't you open it? It's a Wonka's Google Scrumptious Fudge Mallow Delight!
Best of all, Renewal Book will carefully work 2700 RPMs for precisely 62 seconds.
Grandpa, please.
I thought we agreed to give it another ribbon.
Fudge Mallow is the best, you know it.
Another ribbon!
Fudge Mallow!
Who wants
TV. Lucky finder of golden ticket number 4. Here's this TV now. Talk about finding a golden ticket, ma'am.
Well, you see, my dad
has a chit chat, Mom. Didn't I tell you never interrupt? This is the best part. Crack, smack, whack, dead.
Did you see that guy die?
It was so totally awesome.
So we got on this TV, a fat old.
Zip it!
This next show, the suicide bomber dude?
Thank you. the weather turned as cold as Willy Wonka's Sub-Zero Cocoa Ice Cream Supreme. First came the snow, huge flakes drifting down from the steel blue sky. Then came the wind. Jets of freezing cold air came inside the house, under the doors. And there was no place to go, no place to escape it. The four old folks lay huddled silently in their beds, trying to keep the cold out from their old bones. The excitement of the gold ticket for the Bucket family was long forgotten, and all they could really think about doing was trying to keep warm and scrape together enough food to keep their hunger at bay for yet another long, cold day as winter tightened. Mr. Bucket searched for odd jobs like shoveling snow, while Charlie Bucket started a long uphill trek towards school.
Charlie, where's your coat?
I haven't got a coat.
Well, here. Take my scarf. You'll freeze to death.
Thanks. You making the rounds?
Was hoping to. Was just about to head back. Don't want the candy to freeze. Hurry me back up, would you?
Okay.
Say, Charlie, do you mind picking up that other machine for me? Don't want to freeze.
Sure. Look at that. There's a coin lying right here in the snow. A silver dollar. I think you must have dropped this.
Wow. A silver dollar. No, that's not mine. Why don't you take it home to your folks?
You think I should? Maybe I should put them in notice.
The coin has moved all the dirt in the snow for weeks. Take it home, man. Take one of these for yourself, your boy.
Really?
Really, it looks like you're starving.
It's so good. A perfect blend of Belgian dark chocolate and New World Light. The subtle overtones of Moroccan espresso. Oh, Wonka's a genius. Thanks. Well, I better be going to school. Do you think I can maybe have one more? And this time I'll pay for it.
Sure, you know how the boss is about inventory. What'll be a show anyway?
Well, I think I'll get this one for my family. Grandpa Joe likes the Whipple Scrumptious Fudge all of her life, but Grandma Josephine likes the nut arithmetic.
Then you should have the Whipple Scrumptious nut arithmetic totally twisted combo bar. Just out. There you go.
Thank you.
My TV and guest, your golden ticket, please.
What's your golden horse ticket, Professor? There's a Geico and a Nike commercial coming up. And you know, I'll get a Geico and a Nike back to back.
I'm sorry. Here's our ticket for the long guns.
Scrumptious.
Orange.
I'm happy to announce there's no television reception in my factory.
Here she is.
country, I say about 5 million gallons.
Which I am, of course, why not? It could be 5 million and one.
We're both in pipes full.
Ah, one to talk about the church's greedy goodness. Those pipes carry yummy goodness to each and every room of my country.
Imagine those just hot, full of nutty chocolates.
That would be a tragedy. It could damage my
journey by boat.
Please step up and in. Violet, don't lift the boat. You'll only make it sticky.
Oh!
to see more.
Stop. Reverse that.
Ah, I almost forgot about this room.
The fizzy drink room.
Thank you.
good.
Thank you.
Jim, what about Charlie's laptop supply chocolate?
Oh, yeah. Ah. A lifetime's chocolate.
Don't worry. Each kid will receive their lifetime supply of chocolate. But besides that, today is a total waste of time and chocolate. Goodbye, Charlie Bunkerhead. Good day.
Goodbye, Mr. Wonka. Just a moment. Mr. Wonka, I don't deserve a lifetime supply of chocolate. I tasted the fizzy lifting drink, and I broke the rules, and I'm very sorry. But thank you for a wonderful day and the most wonderful tour of your factory. It was better than Christmas.
Bless you, Charlie. You did it. You did it!
Did what, Mr. Wonka?
Oh, no. See you, Mr. Wonka. It wasn't Charlie's fault, it was mine. I commit sin to take a sip of the fizzy lifting drink.
So you're both to blame.
Kind of time that right now.
You see, I created this entire competition with just one thought in mind. To find the next person to make new candy dreams come true.
I don't understand.
The whole thing was a test of character, Charlie. I carefully selected each and every group that would attend each verbal tutor's. You did something quite remarkable. You gave in to temptation.
We're smart enough not to get caught,
but admitted your guilt.
Well now, pick up the pace. We have a lot of writing to do.
Does this mean we're in trouble, Mr. Walker?
I'm not, but you could be. You see, it's always a matter of time until we find ourselves in some sort of life-threatening trouble. Charlie, put that up there.
This one?
No, no, that one didn't come out. That one.
Where are you taking it, Walker? I thought you said the tour was over.
And that was just pure theater. Nothing but cotton candy. And treatable design. Our tour is just beginning. Now, Charlie, press that button there. No, not that one! That one!
Come on.